We're finally getting our first taste of armor set bonuses in Destiny 2. Today I wanted to do my best to explain how these set bonuses work, how you can acquire the actual armor within the set, and how much of an impact they will have on the gameplay. So most of this information is actually coming from an exclusive breakdown of Season of the Drifter from Fireteam Chat. If you want to see the entire talk they had about the new season with Bungie, I'll link that in the description. It's a great episode, I would highly recommend checking it out after this video. So in Season 6, along with the new Gambit Prime mode, which is a one-round, fast-paced, and mechanic-heavy twist from the original Gambit mode, we're also getting Pinnacle Armor sets that cater to a specific playstyle within Gambit. There are four roles that a player should seek to fill in Gambit Prime. Those are the Reaper, who's responsible for slaying a bunch of waves of enemies, the Invader, who of course is going to invade the enemy team, the Collector, whose job is to gather motes and bank them, and then the Sentry, who's responsible for shutting down enemy invaders and protecting the bank from blockers. Each of these roles has an armor set that you'll earn by playing the Reckoning that includes a handful of specific perks unique to that set, as well as what Bungie is calling a pinnacle perk of that role. The more pieces of one of these sets that you wear, the more perks you unlock until you eventually reach the pinnacle perk of that set. Now these perks aren't actually on the armor, they're bonuses that you get from wearing the armor, but the perks aren't directly tied to each piece. This allows you to mix and match different pieces of armor without losing out on some of the lower tier perks that the set can offer. But if you want to go all in on a very specific role, and really take advantage of what that set has to offer, then you're going to want to wear, for example, every single piece of the Red Invader set to get that bonus Pinnacle Invasion perk. Now here's where it gets a little confusing. While wearing a full set of that armor is the primary way of boosting that Pinnacle stat, there is also another way players can take advantage of the bonuses, and that's with consumables. Let's say, for example, that you're wearing three pieces of an Invader set, and you're also wearing two pieces of a Sentry set. If you're close to unlocking the next tier perk for the Sentry set, but you only have those two pieces on, you can use a consumable to boost the Sentry's roll stats to get that next perk unlocked. Now, that might sound really confusing right now, and we don't have a whole lot of information on how the consumables actually work in unlocking the next tier of armor perks, but we do know how consumables work when it comes to the Reckoning mode. These consumables, which Bungie are calling synths, are obtained from completing Gambit Prime matches, and you can also get those synths from doing specific things within Gambit Prime. Bungie has not elaborated on this yet, but I imagine that if you do something like invading, you're more likely to get an invader synth, or if you're a sentry player, then you're more likely to get sentry synths. So then you take these synths and you hop into the Reckoning activity, where you'll deposit these into a bank-like structure, and upon completing a tier of the Reckoning activity, you have a chance to earn a piece of that Gambit armor that corresponds to the synth that you deposited. So if you deposited a Sentry synth, then you'll have a chance to get an armor piece from the Sentry set. This allows the player to grind for the armor as long as you have that consumable, which is super cool. And once you've got this armor from the Reckoning, you can take that back to Gambit Prime and play more to then go back to the Reckoning, etc. So they've developed a hopefully engaging gameplay loop that I'm personally really stoked to try out. The pinnacle perks from the new Gambit armor actually changed the way Gambit Prime works. They'll only be active in Gambit Prime though, because Bungie said that they wanted to, quote, turn things up to 11 with these set bonuses, and to have these be active in the regular Gambit mode would just be too overpowered. So the armor will still have a regular set of rolled perks, as well as a mod slot, so if you like the armor, you can still wear it anywhere you please, but you'll get the most use out of it in Gambit Prime, thanks to the additional bonuses it provides. An example of a pinnacle perk is on the Collector set, where unlocking that top tier perk allows you to carry 20 motes, and you can send over a giant blocker that's even bigger than the 15 mote enemy, which sounds kind of insane. I thought I'd mention this one too because it sounds pretty nutty, but when you unlock the top tier invader bonus, once you jump into the portal and invade the enemy side, it labels you as a blocker, meaning that the bank will shut down for as long as you're invading, and then if you go near the bank, you'll be able to start draining motes, so there's actually an incentive to not just sit back and snipe, but get up close, and hopefully actually really hurt the enemy team that way. So when Bungie said they were turning these perks up to 11, they weren't kidding. These are going to be some really, really strong bonuses that actually have a huge effect on the match, and ones that I know for sure I'm going to want to chase after. So these armor set bonuses impact the way the game mode of Gambit Prime actually functions. But alongside those, there are actually parts of Gambit Prime that are fundamentally different from the way the original game mode works. Like if you have two or more blockers preventing you from depositing motes into your bank will just automatically start draining motes. This means that every single role in Gambit Prime is now much more important and much more crucial to success, and when the game mode first releases, things will be much more tame than in a month later when everyone's got their crazy Gambit sets and are all glowing, because that's when the mode really starts to get chaotic. I think the coolest thing about these new Gambit armor sets is that you can mix and match the armor to get different perks from each role, so you're not just restricted to wearing one armor set to get bonuses. I think armor set bonuses and this type of creativity is really what Destiny needs. Seeing Joker's Wild embracing a deeper RPG system excites me a lot for the future of the series. This should definitely be expanded upon though for like things like raids, and I hope to see armor set bonuses in Penumbra. Maybe the old Leviathan armor can be reworked to be like the Gambit armor. There's just endless possibilities with this system and even just the consumables too. My hope for the future of Destiny is now that Activision's gone, Bungie can shift their focus from how do we bring in new players to how do we satisfy our longtime and hardcore fans who want to get deeply immersed in the game again? And set bonuses to me is just one of the many small steps towards that goal, which I hope Bungie is chasing after. So I'm really curious to hear what you guys think about it, and what Gambit Prime role are you most interested in playing? Let me know in the comments. That's all for this one. Thank you guys for watching.